What's good, my family? Welcome back to the channel. We are coming live. Y'all know we coming live from West 65th in Detroit. Oh, the lighting look good right here, y'all. I'm feeling fucking fantastic today, y'all. Like yesterday, I felt drained. I even woke up this morning and felt drained. But as soon as I came out here and felt this great weather, I was like, oh, hell yeah. But before I go to Gypsy Bean, y'all know I'm out here to go to Gypsy Bean, get some coffee. I'm actually about to go to this bar next door called XYZ. I used to go here in the summer to get like some fries or something. I'm kind of cheap. I don't really get the whole meal, but I do get they fries. And then I go get a coffee, and then I'm at today's vlog. And then we rolling, y'all. I should be done with everything like super duper early today because I don't know, feeling good. When I feel good, I get shit done like a lot quicker than like days I feel like slumped, you dig? But what is being said, today's vlog should be dope. Sorry about yesterday's vlog. I know I didn't really vlog too much stuff. I did a lot of shit yesterday, but today I'm vlogging it all, you dig? XYZ, the tavern. This is what I was talking about, y'all. I'm about to go in here and get some fries. Boom. I should get a drink too, but y'all know I'll be doing Uber. Oh, look at that. Look at that. See, y'all know I'm cheap. I ain't about to get no drink, you know, get some water. You know what I'm saying? Some good old water. But look at these drinks over here, y'all. I guess everybody like this right here, Knob Creek. I never heard of that before. Four Roses? This is some shit I never heard of. You know, I'm trying to get in like to different bourbons and stuff. But me, I'm a tequila man. I'm over here with the Don Julio. You know, I heard that Don Julio fuck you up. But yeah, I'm about to wait for these fries to get here. I'm gonna show y'all when they get out here. And then, yeah, we're on to the next destination. So these are fries I was talking about. Look how crispy they look. Y'all know I like my food crispy. And we got the barbecue sauce right here on the side. And the optional ketchup, you did? About to eat good, y'all. And about to enjoy this great scenic view outside of Cleveland, Ohio. But yeah.
I can feel like in the nighttime. Watch what she do when the light shine. Drunk niggas tryna talk in a strip club. Shorty silhouette look like a dollar sign.
Free 30 minutes always. Y'all should already know where I'm coming from, y'all. I'm about to go over here at Guy's Pizza. Let me zoom in for y'all. Guy's Pizza, get some pizza. Been no Uber for the last few hours. You know what, y'all? They must love my sticker. It been here for like 2 months now. Let's see, they got it. Ooh, I only have a few slices left, y'all. This is rare, this is rare. I'm getting this one right here. This one look real good. Boom, today was an overall great day, y'all. You know what? I got shit done. I edited some old podcasts. I edited today's vlog. And I had some coffee at Gypsy Bean. It tasted really good. You know what, y'all? Y'all know I'm a big time coffee drinker. And every day coffee does not taste, you know, like that. Ooh, you ever drink a cup of coffee and just tastes like a regular cup of coffee? And then you drink like a cup of coffee the next day and tastes like a, ooh, this is a sensational crisp cup of coffee. That's how today's coffee was, y'all. And it kept me rolling all night. Did Uber all night. Of course, the big talk was the coronavirus. Not gonna talk about that too much. But besides all that, y'all, today was a smooth day, good day. And y'all know the weekend is approaching, so therefore I'm hustling all weekend. I actually got a podcast on Saturday. Looking forward to my brother King Zale. My second time doing a podcast with him. You know, a lot of people I'm doing right now, I have did a podcast with before. It's like we're kind of catching up in a way. It's also helping me to, you know, get more podcasts out there so I can rebrand myself and re-promote myself so people can come back hitting me up to get on the show and everything. Y'all know it's all about marketing, you dig? Marketing and networking. But got the fun facts of the day for y'all. And by the way, I actually did the fun facts yesterday as well too. I just didn't put it in the vlog because I didn't want to put it in there. It's like that vlog would have been too long, you know what I mean? So, and they, I make these vlogs compared to how I want to watch them as well. Because I watch YouTube vlogs, and sometimes I don't like watching vlogs that's too long. I think yesterday's vlog would have been too long. So that's why I put that in there. But I do have a question in here. Well, I do have a question from yesterday that I answered that I want to answer today as well, just to document it. But let's get to it. Thought of the day. To listen well is as powerful as means of influence as to talk well. What? Hold on. To listen well is as powerful a means of influence as to talk well. Either I'm tripping, they grammar fucked up. You know what? I know sometimes they like to say, oh yeah, you're not saying the words proper, but this don't make no sense, y'all. I'm gonna read it really slow, y'all. And tell me, does this make sense? To listen well is as powerful a means of influence as to talk well. either I'm slow, y'all, or I don't know. You know what? I don't know. I just know the thought is trying to tell us to listen. That's the only thing I know, y'all. I went to college for 7 years, and I'm not the perfect person with grammar. Obviously, I stutter and shit, but listen, man, this don't make no goddamn sense. Joke of the day. How do you scramble eggs? G-E-S-G. Oh, they got me on that one. I was about to get mad again. Say, what are y'all talking about today? You get it, y'all? How do you scramble eggs? G-E-S-G. The words are scrambled. The eggs are scrambled. That's a good one. That's a real good one, y'all. Random fact of the day. If you never cut your hair, it will likely stop growing at about 2 feet long. You know, that's interesting because I was out in New York like 2 years ago, right? And I saw this one guy. His dreads went way down to by his ankles. And I was about to go ask him how long it take to grow his hair out. And he, you know what? He was a fucking asshole. I was like, hey, what's up, brother? How long it take you to grow your... No questions. I was like, quick question. No questions. I was like, question. No questions. I was like, well, fuck you. You know what? And that day changed my life. That shows that us brothers, man, we need to stick together, man, because he was an asshole, man. Hopefully, he found some light in his life, because I just had a simple question. The question was, how long it take you to grow your dreads? I'm sure you get asked that question a lot, but you cannot expect to have no dreads going down to your ankles and people not to ask you no questions, man. So, you ever watch this? But I still love you, my brother. But that's crazy, though. You know, the longest I grew my hair for was like 3 months, and that's when I was pledging for my fraternity. I let my hair grow for a good while. It didn't get too long. It had like a little mini afro, nothing too massive. Journal entry idea. What types of transportation do you think people will have in the future? You know what? They say flying cars is already here. We just can't afford them. We just got to be billionaires and millionaires. But I think the transportation will be the same. I think it's still going to be cars. I think, you know, obviously y'all be seeing little scooters going around downtown. I feel like transportation is going to be the same, just a little more quicker. You know what I mean? I feel like the scooters may have like a little more speed to them, or they may be more, what's it called, hoverboards or whatever. But I feel like transportation is going to be the same. You know what I mean? I feel like it's going to get better. Such as me being an Uber driver, I'm a mode of transportation. You know what I mean? People just go on their phone, pick up where they want, put in where they want to get picked up from. I pick them up, I take them to destination, I'm on to the next. So I feel like, you know, at the end of the day, it's still a car. You know what I mean? So I guess it's going to be the same, just more quicker. That's one thing I think. Everything becomes more convenient and more quicker. But the question that was on here yesterday, it was actually a journal entry idea. And let's go back to it real quick. So I want to actually re-answer that question because I want to document that, you know. Y'all know I like manifesting a lot of things through my vlogs. All right, here we go. Journal entry idea. Write about your dream house. What would it be inside? Okay, y'all. So I got to put this in here, y'all. Ever since I was a little kid, I always said my first house was going to be built from the ground up. And I'm still sticking to that. I know right now y'all see me in my parents' house. I had my apartment just a year and a half ago. But after I leave here, I plan on moving to like a nice-ass loft or condo or whatever it is. You know what I mean? But I want my house built from the ground up, y'all. And the way I imagine it is, you know, you see those big-ass mansions and you see those driveways. But I want the driveway with the gate and I want a roundabout, right? And as soon as you get to the front door, I want those two big-ass massive doors you open up. And as soon as you open up, I want you to look up, see a big-ass chandelier and like a big majestic wall, like with a whole bunch of angels and shit on it. And I want a big glass chandelier, not a little, here, I got a chandelier. I want a big-ass glass chandelier. And I'm going to also have like the stair rails that curl in, you know what I mean? That it has two sides and they curl in, they go upstairs, y'all. And I plan on having a basketball court, a pool, a bar, somewhere to kick it, like a chill room, you know what I mean? And just, I want to have like parties a lot also. You know who really inspired me to have like, not to have, I'm not doing it yet, but I'm going to do it. Who, you know, long story short, The Great Gatsby inspired me, y'all. When I saw that movie and I saw his house, and I saw him throwing parties. I was like, you know what? I want that. And I saw that vision, and ever since then, it's been stuck in my head, you dig? So, yeah, my first house will be built from the ground up, man, you know, and I'm going to stick to that vision, you feel me? I stay in condos and lofts as long as I have to, because I want my first crib to be built from the ground up looking real nice, y'all. I know y'all probably like, what? But, yeah, you know, I'm manifesting it. That's why I actually went back to this question and put in today's vlog, because I want to be able to document this. So, if that happens, or when it does happen, I could come back, take this clip right here and post it on social media with me in front of my house, you dig? But what has been said, my family, tomorrow, y'all know it's a grind day as always. I've been grinding every fucking day. I'm gonna keep on grinding for the next few months to get this money up. Y'all should be grinding as well, you dig? But what has been said, my family, I'm gonna see y'all tomorrow. Take it easy, have fun, enjoy the journey. Peace and love.